For compensation of static work, we have static work compensator, which is fully automatic and responds very rapidly with the system load change. And if it can compensate that load change or voltage change, then we can achieve the reactive power compensation. Generally, static power compensator is not done at the line voltage because it requires very high capacity switching devices, and we know that electronic devices with high capacity are very costlier. So we will reduce the voltage to the usable form with this transformer. Then we use this SCR band for switching purpose. Then the power system reactive load is capacitive leading, the static voltage compensator will use reactor to supply voltage to the system through this inductor, which I am highlighting with my arrow. And if the power system reactive load is an inductive or lagging, we have to use static voltage compensator for capacitor band to absorb the voltage from the system. So this is the very simple way we can achieve the reactive power compensation. Means either if the system going in leading, that is also not beneficial. If it is in much lagging, that is also not beneficial. Hence we have to keep the system unity form or near to unity power factor. For that purpose we have this setup. Now as we know, our compensator is running on lower voltage. And if the system is running on lower voltage, that means it carried out high current. So for that purpose, we need thick conductors, but that is also not good for the system. And for that purpose, we have to use a very high quality material for the compensator connections to reduce the size of conductor. The thyristors are very important in our SVC. Also, thyristors are called as wands because they are switching. So that's why you can also use the word walls for them. They are like in disc shape semiconductor, several inches of diameter, and they are installed in the wall mounts. And the ability of these walls or thyristors is they can switch the capacitors on per cycle basis, capacitor or inductor, whatever the system demand, reactive power absorption or deliver, that can be controlled as per cycle by using this thyristors or valves. Therefore, very fast and fine control of system has been achieved because of using this valves. Thyristors are electrically controlled and these thyristors are electronically controlled, so the operating is very fast and the control signal has been carried out with the fiber optic cables or power pulse transformer. As we know, fiber optic cables having very rapid speed capacity, and pulse transformer having the major advantage, that is it will isolate the system, higher voltage system from lower voltage system. So we use any one of them to get rapid switching as well as protection for the lower voltage side installation, that is our compensator. And when this switching is going on, thyristors are creating fair amount of heat, so we have to provide the coolant for this system is very mandatory. And for that purpose we use deionized water for cooling of valve. Next technique is system voltage optimization and phase current balancing. Voltage balancing, as we know, the imbalancing of voltage is depend on the length of each feeder. So we have to consider this important thing, and we have to select the appropriate phase for delivering the voltage or delivering the supply to the particular load. In this method, we are not going to select three phase load, as they are three phase, so we assume them as a balanced load. So we are going to only concentrate on the single phase load which are connected through the three phase system. Now If we have one single phase load, then we have three options to connect them, like R, Y or B. So we have to select appropriate phase as per the load demand and availability of phase. Now if we have two loads, then we have six type of different configuration, like RY, YB, BY, like that. We have six type of option to connect that load to get the balancing in voltage. So this way we will do the voltage balancing. For current balancing, we have to follow all the steps which I have mentioned in voltage balancing, like appropriate phase selection, appropriate configuration of connection, like possibility we have for two load connection, we have six options available to configure or to connect in that configuration. So we have to follow them, and also including this, for current balancing we have to select or we have to consider multiple feeders for that. So which feeder is better for that load, that the load should be connected to that feeder. Next is by using energy efficient transformer. Typically in distribution grids, transformer power loss is around 40-50% of total transmission and distribution losses. Hence it is very important to compensate this 40-50% losses, as transformer is responsible for variable as well as fixed losses in the system, and its replacement is easier than changing cable or replacing the entire line. Life of transformer is around 40 years. So see, if we will select any ordinary transformer, then it will deliver till 40 years. So it is not good for our system. That's why we have to consider the transformer for a replacement with the energy efficient transformer. Also, the replacement of transformer is very easier as compared with the replacement of different cable connected to the system or entire transmission line. And how we can replace it? For that purpose, we have to consider some important things like population density, characteristics of transformer, the age of transformer, the size of transformer or type of transformer. Because see, if we just installed one transformer and suddenly someone suggested us that just replace this transformer with a good quality energy efficient transformer, then we have to first of all compare the payback period of after installing the energy efficient transformer, how much time it will take to pay back, and we have to compare that cost with the latest installed our transformer. If which one is good, that we must have to select, because cost is the very important factor in all these things. For all the conservation area, cost is always constant. We must have to consider the cost. Energy efficiency can be achieved by the transformer, but we must have to compare our current transformer with energy efficient transformer on the behalf of population of this area. Means it is efficient to replace the transformer if the population density is very high, then we can think about that. But if the population is less, then why should we replace? As power consumption is reduced less, then we don't need to replace it. Also, its age or size and type of transformer, and with its characteristic, means which type of transformer is that, that is we must have to select. So by doing this, we can achieve our reduction in technical losses. In next part, I am going to explain you about our distribution losses. So please like, share and subscribe my channel. Please press the bell icon so you will get the notification